Katie's always been a deep soul. Katie was a deep soul when she was a young kid.
She started playing soccer when she was about 4 years old, and she was a very aggressive soccer player. It took a while for her to warm up to people, but once she did, they were her best buddies.
It's probably very difficult for you to think about and to talk about, but bring me back to when you were 18. What was life like?
I was very, very interested. Start college, grow up, and do something with my life. I was very, very determined. I've always been very determined. But I was extra determined when I was 18. I had several different things going on in my life with relationships and struggles. I allowed those things to get the best of me.
When I got to Robert's house, she was sitting in a big fluffy chair with her legs over it, and she was texting. And I went over to her and I said, "How you doing?" And she just kind of shrugged her shoulders like a teenager sometimes will. And I didn't feel an alarm. I just felt like my girl had gotten hurt.
I asked her what was not happening. What happened?
I remember we were walking up and we heard this, you know, like a loud. So then I walked in and I looked in the chair and she wasn't in the chair. Didn't get alarmed then. I walked to the kitchen, looked, went on this back patio, little porch, you know, and I saw the bathroom door shut. Twisted the door and I said, "Katie, you okay?" And she didn't answer. My son picks me up and takes me through the living room outside in the yard and just stands me there and says, "Mom, Katie got my gun and I don't know, she's hurt."
She'll never eat, she'll never drink, she'll never bathe herself, she'll never converse, she'll be a vegetable, she'll just be in a skilled facility for the rest of her life. And so I said, "I'm not ready to let go of my daughter. I'm just not." And I mean, you don't, in that moment, you think you're gonna have great courage and stamina, but you're just as feeble as a feather in the wind. Your heart is in your throat, but yet out of the depths of your gut, your soul, your heart, no, we're not going to let go.
I had complete recollection of what I had done to it. I thought, "What have I done to myself?" But more importantly, "What have I done to my family?" To have my life back and my faith back and thank God.
Was that a big decision to make?
It was a very good decision because I knew someone would have compassion or willing to have their faith. someone who don't keep coming to me saying, because I'm nervous. I said, I'm sorry, I get to take a 31-hour nap is going to be the best nap of my entire life. It truly was the best nap I had ever taken.
This is like they gave me another chapter.
I think I was trying to look for old characteristics, if I could see anything from the pre-accident Katie or the pre-injury. And I don't think I did. It was very surreal. I remember thinking, where is Katie, you know? At the same time, so grateful that she's alive and so grateful that she didn't have to walk around the rest of her life without a face. But it was hard. I grieved her old face a lot, I have to be honest.
Katie, do you still think about and long for the things that you wanted when you were 18, like to meet someone and fall in love? And I can see you smiling now.
I want to go to college and have my career like I want to teach them or possibly in counseling. And I would like to meet someone and get married and have my own family someday.
Of course, this is not the story I would have written for her. But I feel like there's a reason. You know, she's here. There's a lot to learn. There's a lot in this whole story with Katie. But I don't think her life is over.
Living in what a dick, wonderful, tremendous dick.